How fares your search? Well, let's hear. Forgive me. It is unlike Theos to leave with. He did not aid you as you'd hoped, I take it. This news of yours makes sense. That isn't enough to take to the Duke. Yes?
Hey.
Good day to you. Hail, traveler.
The Temple of Barath went through a number of changes in development, in part because our artists became more comfortable with our pipeline and could push art in various ways. We also quickly learned about some of our limitations. Windows, for instance, became a contentious point in most maps. Since the game incorporates a day-night cycle, we either needed to reflect the time of day outside the window somehow or obscure them. We learned this lesson later on that dynamic objects and scenes can enhance, but the more reliance we had on them, the less the painterly feel we had for our scenes. So for the instance of the windows, we felt obscuring them where we could help. So drapes were added later on in the scene, which overall give the room more of a moody vibe. This may be a very familiar scene for some of our backers, as the overall region of Deerford is what we use in our backer beta. What you may not know is that Deerford Village was among the first maps ever made in development. The Deerford region in Pillars of Eternity was made during a phase of development we call vertical slice. If each feature of a game were made into a layer of a cake, then taking a vertical slice of said cake would result in a small section of the entire game that includes all the various layers of gameplay. In this period, we get all the core mechanics of the game in a raw form, so that we can get an immediate sense of the experience we're aiming for the player. Deerford, a seemingly remote village in Deerwood, felt like a perfect fit. As our visual target, we wanted to create a village familiar to a fantasy setting, but grounded in a historic medieval feel. In terms of the area design, since Deerford is such a tight-knit village where everyone knows each other, it only felt logical that all their quests... The Deerford Mill was a late addition to the Deerford Village. For a while, the mill was just a landmark in the exterior, a piece of scenery, but not a place you could
enter. Over there.
However, once we began QA on the project, one of the first things we noticed is that literally everyone tried to enter this building.
Margaret's fire casts light in dark places. Hail, traveler. Greetings.
I actually watched through all of the guild before working on this inn. I wanted to make sure it had enough of the right elements to represent its backer.
Hello.
When I got to the episode with the Highlander painting, I knew it had to be in the inn somewhere. The table locations with the banners next to them are also a nod to the episode where the Knights of Good are sent to the back of the line outside of a game store. In this inn, they get the table in the back as represented by their banner on the wall.
We're decent folk, my lord. Perhaps you should leave and check the wilds.
My child, my lord. Beasts take them all. I don't care how you do.
Yes, Lady Ali. I've asked around, but nobody in this mud hole has any concerns beyond their swine. Elise. A petty, small-minded man. Just... I'm Lord Nestor.
Welcome! Hail, traveler.
And what does the flame reveal? Something over there! I can do that. That's settled. I can do that. A simple test. That's settled.
Be cautious. Be...
There's an odor that could sear the memories from your skull.
Hello. Welcome. Good day, stranger.
Something over there.
Two whispers and shadows. I am seen, but the eyes of others do not remember. Your memories. The storm that brushed you. Did it scream? You are able to see me. To see me is a rare gift. A watcher's gift. So many questions. The fact that you could hear it at all